Eng Soon, Microsoft MVP, around, yeah, this year is 5 years of my Microsoft MVP. Okay, I want to ask, you all know when Microsoft released the PowerApp? Anyone know? Not this year. No. Don't know, right? At the end of 2015, year end. That's why I always mention you can not always watch the video from the Microsoft view. You also need to watch the video from the Microsoft Ignite. Because a lot of time I share the topic inside the meetup or event, they say Microsoft just released this product. Actually no. Actually it's a few years ago. During last year. But they say that they really don't know what I'm talking about. Yes, Siri. Okay. I want to share about what is AI Builder. Maybe you don't have this access from your company. This one is my own 365 subscription. Okay. I know last few months, Satya is announced that citizen developer. A lot of people concept is already wrong because every day they think that actually no need to code. Actually it's code less. Because something you still need to write little of code, like not more than 50 words. Yeah. Because every time you say you think that every time you need to wait for your developer to deliver. For example, last week, Friday, my director asked me to write a PowerShell. I don't know. Then I go for research everything until today. I just finished my project for PowerShell. That means that need 2 weeks. If you know how the application works, then you know how to link everything and drag and drop, then publish your application. Okay, PowerApps have been released in 2015, year end. Okay. It helps non-developer to create their own application using the old G5 account. That means that even you got O365 account, don't have some features, you also cannot access to the Power App, also Power BI, and also Microsoft Flow. Microsoft Flow, yeah, correct. Power App has the ability to get the data from 100 resources, create an application with multiple page for mobile or tablet. AI Builder. It's just released a few months ago. AI Builder is a new power platform capability that allows you easily to automate, process and predict outcome to help improve the business performance. Using the AI Builder, you can use the add on the intelligent AI to your application even you does not have the coding or data science skill. Because every time when you ask the developer who up data machine learning knowledge, then to develop application without machine learning, they will say I'm not a data scientist, I cannot develop the application. Actually, you can use the web API. But today, I will not show you with how to integrate with the web API. Actually, just now, Maureen already show you. For the high level view of the process, at first, you need to select a model type that will include the binary classification, form processing, object detection, text classification. The Microsoft already released 4 templates for you. Then I will discuss later. Then connect the model to a data, AI builder, and train the model based on the data that we cite with a common data service. Because Microsoft already have previewed database inside PowerApp, then you can integrate. Then after that, you need to train. Train is an automated process handled by the AI builder services based on the previous provider input. Then after that, you probably need to publish your application to let other people use your application. Okay, this is the 4 template that Microsoft released for the public, but currently you only can use in the preview mode. But I hear from there, they say that coming soon will be charging for this one. The form processing. Today, I also want to talk about form processing, but without coding. Object detection. Object detection means that you, at the back end, you still need to change some data from the custom mission, then you integrate the custom vision and implement inside your object detection application. And the last one is the task configuration. The task configuration, that means that they can separate out this word is from is which language, and is that is a how to say is that a bad word or some emotional word, they also can detect. Okay, how to access it? If you want to try out, you can ask your company and all choose by me to give you access. They say they don't know, please refer to my slide. Okay, at first, you go to your admin center, powerapps.microsoft.com. And ask them to ask them to enable these features currently still in preview mode. After that, assign them his job already done. Don't need to care about you already. Okay, currently after that you need to create your environment, but currently you only can select United States environment product part. Environment type is production or trial. Then after that, you open your environment at the application you had created here for the prerequisite. All choose by account. A lot of people don't know how to differentiate all choose by account and also normal Outlook account, because normal Outlook account maybe some third party email account, they also can use the Outlook. Office Fine account, if you look for if Office Fine account, you can do a lot of things. For example, like Microsoft Teams, then Power BI, Microsoft Word, then a lot of things you can do. But still got some limited. Sometimes it's you need to pay more money to do it. Yeah. If not, Microsoft helps to earn money. Okay, let's go for demo form processing. If today, I think got time, still got time. Okay, step one, build, train, and publish an AI model. After you log into your portal, then you select form processing, then provide your model a name and click create. Why I all the demo and step by step I screenshot, that means because a lot of time because this one only has 28 days for me prior. If next time I will not talk about this, but I still can show you. This is the way to do it. Because after 28 days, say I still need to recreate or they got update, because just now I just use my phone application. They got some update from the AI builder. So that if, because just now can't recognize the phone from my mobile phone. Okay, after that you need to add the document. For example, like a lot of forms, as a sample data from home. This one is not from home. This one from myself. The data. Okay, you just click open. Then upload it. Then sure need to close it because last minute you want to cancel upload wrong data. Okay. After that, you need to select analyze. Then wait for training a few minutes. This one will be take longer, depend on your file size and also your number of documents. The more you train, then I think they currently allow until 100 documents. More than that, you need to pay already. Okay, after that, click the tile to open the form. This is the document. If different document, you still need to adjust it. For example, like currently your invoice is like different. Last few years ago, we are GST, then you have another format. Okay. After that, you go to select your field at my right side, your left hand side. Then you select a few, click a pencil. Then if you want to change the name, then click tick. Then change, repeat the steps, whatever you want to change. Then make sure everything, ensure that to check that all changes have been confirmed by clicking tick at the left hand side after rename the field, and that all the fields are selected with the purple tick on the left hand side of each field. Yes?
This list of field is on the form with the form with identifier, or we can you go back to the form?
This is what they found
out. So we identify all the fields.
Yes. You want to change or don't want to change your program.
So for invoice code, we're choosing this one. So some other document because of different documents.
Yeah, different document you need to rearrange again.
So these are the pre-selected
fields. Yes, pre-selected.
More relevant fields they provided.
Yeah, that's right. Or you don't want to change your program. Okay, after that, we change. Then next, and you need to train your Power App, your model. Then after that, go to detail page. After detail page, you need to publish your application. But this one you only have your data, everything, you can't do anything. We are an app, you do nothing from here. Okay, that's step two. Actually, many steps. That's why I screenshot. Okay, this. Okay, great. After train the data, publish the data, you need to create an app. Then select Canvas template. And here, you can, for my case study, you can outstanding. Okay, just keep the welcome note because most irritating. Okay, now after that, because just now at the beginning you already enable your AI builder. If you does not enable the AI builder, AI builder, then you can't see this one form processor. Then after that, you select form processing model. If you are in shared environment, there may be a lot of data, number of model in the list. Then this one is what I train the model. Then drag and drop it from the left hand side to the right side. Then click the analyze and no play. The place it here. Then after that, click analyze. Then you just select any sample data from the resources and click open, then you automatically help you detect the thing is whether it's accurate. When you see 53 from yellow to red, you better check again at your training model at the beginning. Then after that, close it because you're happy already. You close it and you again because it's motivation. Then after that you insert a label because I want to capture some data from the invoice automatically. Okay, and here what I say that always why is copless not copless? Actually copless you can do it here. Copless you right at here, because normally as a developer, really hit drag and drop or use the property. I know use the property is more easier, but sometimes there are limitations for as a developer. Okay, and here you just change the font size, then font type, then data table, insert, create a data table, then close the data panel, then drag the data table to a bottom, then select the data table by clicking the object to bring it into focus, then update the items. Then after that, choose which of the field you need it. For example, like the form, I need an item, quantity, unit price, and amount. Then after that, you just close it. While holding now shift key, because now shift key, then click the following three column. So quantity, unit price, and amount. Then after that, release it. Then change the width and also control because I don't want it to add on again. Now after that, you change a lot of things. Then you understand the fundamental of being able to map the form. Form field value to a label. Repeat this process until the app looks like at the right hand side. Okay, at the end of the result, you can see the beautiful data, the form, the data set. And after that, step three. Okay, see that how they publish. At first, you need to download our Power App inside your mobile app. This is iPhone. Then log in with your Word and school account, Word or school account. Normally, it's the your company. .com or .net. Okay, log in with it. You log in one time, can already. Then you just have already published the application. Then you just use the application to capture the photo or from library. Then you capture. Give you the result. Yeah, that's all. That's all for my demo. Okay, if you want to do around four templates. For template, I got four tutorials at the AI Builder Lab. Then, if you want to get a training, you go for the Open EDS, Microsoft Open EDS. Because inside got a lot of people, got a lot of people asking about how I get the training for the Microsoft Power Platform. Then you can go for the Microsoft Open EDS. Inside got Azure training, M365, data science, and also this M365 thing. And inside my GitHub, all the URL I already provide to you. But I am not guarantee for you passing the exam. Okay? Because currently a lot of people complain to me already. They want to get 800 marks, but they just pass around 700 to 720 only. If you want to see more about the other Microsoft technology, please go to my YouTube channel, because more onwards I will share about the Microsoft security, because currently a lot of people not really understand about security. But I will not teach you how to hack. Anything happen, I die. Okay. Okay, that's all for today. Thank you very much.
So you take it from the form to another new format form, right?
Yes. So I think the one is analyze, is take the photo.